Dearie, would you come here a minute, please?
Not now, Grandma. I'm busy.
But darling, we've only gone through the first three volumes of my old photos. Now get over here and shut the hell up.
Fine.
Now this was our old dog. Skipper was his name, I believe. I used to love going on long walks in the summer with him. Believe me, he sure was delicious. Mm. And this is our family reunion at the Southern Food Festival. And that's me with the deep fried butter on a skewer. Oh. And this is your dear Uncle Billy wading through a pile of cow sh**. Ah, the memories.
Hello, viewers. I am Sir Robert Smith, and the scene was set in Prague, 1618. The world watched with bated breath as the most highly charged confrontation between the Protestants and the Texans the world had ever seen was soon to be underway. Due to a lack of planning and communication, however, the Texans were unable to make an appearance and were henceforth represented by the Catholics for the rest of the film. Unfortunately, contemporary Prague was suffering from one of the greatest architectural setbacks in its history. In the midst of the social upheaval brought about by the revived post-colorism movement, represented by the lovely picture to my left, which, at 500,000 euros, was quite the steal. Overeager young engineers in Prague, who were working tirelessly to catch up with the post-colorism movement, accidentally invented stairs that were optimized for upwards use only. In fact, dual-directional stairs would not be invented until Sir Desmond Case invented what is now known as the Timeless Staircase in 1691. Rather than suffer the shame and degradation of using an inefficient means of descent, the proud citizens of Prague chose instead to employ the ancient tradition of window jumping. They decided to install cattle fueled with Taco Bell bean burritos outside of dwellings, such that the explosive excrement of said creatures might lessen the impact upon the conclusion of the multi-story plummet. Unfortunately, it was this tradition which ultimately brought the Holy Roman Empire to, and later over, the brink of war. Oh, it's you, good butler. And what is that you have with you?
Our little bunch of cake has arrived as requested, sir.
Oh, look at that delicious pencil of frosting. Delicious.
And right on time, too. The party starts at 4. The Catholics will be here any minute now.
Good work, butler. You're dismissed.
Thank you, sir. Sir, the cow pie is wearing thin.
Lucy! More bean burritos!
Hello, hello, we are finally here.
You filthy heretics!
Shh! You can't say that in polite company. Now where's the booze, you evil, good-for-nothing sinners?
Oh, my bad, I forgot the little bit of whiskey. I'll go get it right now.
It appears a stray wind has blown our friend off the target. A pity. He was a good man.
What in God's name happened?
Well, an unfortunate gust of wind blew our friend off the target, and he made an unfortunate rendezvous with the ground. I wish I could say he died for some greater, nobler cause, but as it turns out, a little bunch of whiskey was here the whole time. Hello.
Smith.
Robert Smith here. So the Catholics and the Protestants began their negotiations. Negotiations of such a magnitude that they permanently altered the course of history for the Holy Roman Empire and beyond. After a few rounds of good-spirited fun and low-budget whiskey, the delegates decided to sign a historic document which would be legally binding and would serve to end warfare among the German states, free the serfs, free all princesses, give freedom to the Jews, slay all dragons, and stop Kony in 2012. Unfortunately, and one of Mage's crueler acts, Catholic number two, in a fit of drunken rage, accidentally spilled the rest of the low-budget whiskey onto the contract, thus nullifying this precious document's legal value. At long last, the intense political and philosophical debates reached a standstill, and thereafter began to drop in severity.
That was terrible. Oh, look at the time. The party's long since expired, and my guests are still here. There's several concubines will be missing them. I better somehow get them over this ledge. One more. Hopefully no wind this time.
Good evening, my lovely in-studio audience. It's me, once again, your beautiful host,
Robert Smith.
Yeah, it's that. The Catholics awoke from the previous night's adventures with a dreadful throbbing in their cerebral regions. The only thing they remembered was being thrown out of the window by the Protestants. They immediately thought that the Protestants had tried to kill them, and it was only by the good grace of God that the cow had pooped in just the right location to save their lives. They ran home and immediately declared war on them, in what would soon be known as one of the bloodiest conflicts in French history.
German, sir.
What? It's not French, it's German?
It's most certainly German, sir.
My intern tells me it's German. Anyway, whatever it is. Historians later call this event the 30 Years' War.
I see trees of green. I see them blue for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.